Consider this simple question that more than 50% of Harvard students got wrong. A bat and a ball costs $1.10. The bat costs $1 more than the ball. So, how much does the ball cost? 10 cents, right? Well, that may be your initial instinct, but the correct answer is 5 cents. This trick question is the first one that appears on the cognitive reflection test, a simple test with only 3 questions. Professor Shane Frederick from Yale University designed the measure to test how well people could suppress their initial reaction in favor of a more thought-out answer. Now, he gave this test to about 3,500 people, most of them being college students. Yet, in the end, he found that only 17% could get all 3 correct. This is concerning because other researchers have found that the worse you perform on this test, the more prone you are to cognitive biases. Furthermore, your score on this test also correlates with your SAT scores. So, for only 3 questions, it's quite a revealing measure. Yet, there's a surprisingly simple way to improve your performance on this test. If you present the questions in a harder-to-read font, this time, 65% of people get all 3 questions correct. It's a staggering improvement. What's more surprising is that this strange effect of font shows up in a variety of other circumstances. For example, fonts that are harder to read also improve memory and learning. In one public school in Ohio, researchers asked teachers to change the font used in their worksheets and PowerPoint presentations. Instead of the usual Times New Roman or Arial, students would now have to read fonts like Monotype Corsiva. Now, you'd think that this would actually hinder the learning process, right? Yet, compared to classes with the normal font, these students scored significantly higher in their later tests. So, why does this happen? Well, this effect reveals an interesting fact about how our brains process information. You may have heard that we have 2 distinct patterns of thinking, System 1 and System 2. System 1 thinking is quick, intuitive, and effortless. It's the type of processing that helps you instantly recognize faces, answer questions like 1 plus 1, and say 10 cents to the bat and ball problem. On the other hand, System 2 thinking is slow, analytical, and more effortful. This is the one that kicks in when you concentrate on a problem, and the one that said 5 cents to the bat and ball problem. Now, it's important to note that most of the time, our brains are operating on System 1 thinking. But there are a few things that will alert the brain to switch to System 2. One of them is cognitive strain. If something is hard to process, your brain will switch to a more deliberate type of thinking. And so, one way of increasing cognitive strain is to use a harder-to-read font. This is why people normally fail the cognitive reflection test, but when you use a harder-to-read font, they're suddenly thinking more carefully. As for the effect it has on learning, here, a harder-to-read font would induce a deeper processing of information, leading to better understanding. Now, unfortunately, this effect can also be used to fool you. For example, if researchers present a statement like, "Adolf Hitler was born in 1892, in a more readable font, participants will rate it as being truer and will believe it comes from a more expert source. This is because without that cognitive strain, we are less likely to question these types of statements. So, how can you use this effect to your advantage? Well, here's one trick you can apply it to. Let's say you've written a resume or essay and need to proofread it. Since the words are so familiar to you, a lot of typos fall through. However, next time, try changing the size and font to a more difficult to read one. By increasing cognitive strain, you'll use more of your System 2 thinking and hence be better at spotting typos. Also, in case you were wondering, here are the 2 other questions in the cognitive reflection test.